Your business partner is fantastic, but does that mean you trust them with your family's financial future? Joining us on today's coffee break is Jacqueline Knobloch, estate planning advisor at Raymond James. Jacqueline, welcome.
Thank you very much for having me, Sybil.
So, Jacqueline, let's dig into this. What do business owners need to consider to ensure that their family's financial future is really secure?
Business owners quite often have much of their wealth tied up in their business, but unfortunately, I find that a lot of business owners with partners, whether that be one other person or several, don't often have a great buy-sell agreement that actually outlines how to dissolve the business should one or more of the partners need to exit.
So, what is in a buy-sell agreement? What does it do? Who needs one?
So basically, any business owner that has one or more partners needs a buy-sell agreement. The reason being that it provides different scenarios that could happen over the life cycle of a business, and it gives different options to say, in this possible scenario, here's how one or more of the partners might be able to exit the business. And this really provides structure to how someone gets funded for their shares and all the time and energy they've then put into the business. So the last thing you want is someone, heaven forbid, having a serious medical condition or possibly death. All of a sudden, a family now dealing with the loss of a spouse is trying to now negotiate with the other business owners on how to get properly funded for all the effort of that individual.
Yeah, that would be a nightmare. So every business owner should have one of these.
Completely.
And what are some of the pitfalls if they don't? Can you share a short case study or an example of a disaster scenario?
So even if you have just two partners and they might be the best of friends and they went into a business with the best of intentions, if someone passes away early, all of a sudden the risk and the effort and the stress of that business now falls on the other individual. And as much as the families might be very tied together, they may inherently have some concerns about the fair share of how much should be paid to the surviving family. And also, it's not necessarily that every business has extra funds available to just pay out potentially millions of dollars to another family. So you really need to consider not only how shares can get funded and how money can get out to the family, but if the capital is available to do so. So if you don't have that funding there, you're really putting at a risk on the business on how they then have to make decisions to get it. And you're putting a risk on that family because they might need those funds to survive the regular lifestyle. And without it, now you've got further injury on the family after they've just lost someone.
Yeah, or even worse yet, maybe the family wants to keep their shares in the business and run the business and know nothing about it. I'm sure when business owners get together, they do so for a reason, and they maybe weren't planning on being business with the family.
Completely.
So you need to know who's going to buy the business, the price, and how to pay for it. Where do people go to get a buy-sell agreement drafted?
So you want to go to your lawyer. Quite often, depending on the financial planner that you work with, they might be able to help guide you on walking through some scenarios before you get to that lawyer meeting. But ultimately, a lawyer is going to help you draft up the scenarios, draft up the document, and make sure that you've got proper legal representation on both sides to make sure that it's fair.
Well, Jacqueline, thanks. This has been helpful. I think we will definitely add a resource to the Wealthy Life for people to get started and start to consider all of the things they may need to include in the buy-sell agreement. And viewers, if you enjoyed this and want to learn how to make smarter financial decisions, go to thewealthylife.com. That's our coffee break. See you next time.